Search engine optimization, otherwise known as SEO, is a process to rank your pages high in the search engine results. And this is important because money and fame are not on page 99. Now, there are two parts to this process, on-page SEO and off-page SEO. On-page SEO, as you can probably guess, is everything you can do on a page to optimize it, such as giving it a good title that describes what the content is about and making it compelling enough for somebody to actually want to read it. And the same goes for your content. Your content must be good and engaging. If people are exiting your page within seconds, that can signal to a search engine that your content is either not very good or it's attracting the wrong audience, which means the search engine is confused about your page. It doesn't know what it's about and it doesn't know who it's for. And all that can hurt your rankings. And yes, good old Google can tell how long people are spending on your pages. The time on page metric takes care of that. This is why your content needs to be good. Off-page SEO, on the other hand, is everything you can do outside of your website to promote your content, such as tweeting about your content or publishing a press release. The trick here is to include a link back to your content. This practice is known as link building, and when done correctly, can boost your domain authority, which in turn will help your pages rank higher. Now, if all this seems like a lot of work, just know that the potential ROI from good SEO is worth it. Trillions of searches take place online every year. I make quite a few of those myself. But seriously, if you're in business, higher rankings means more traffic, which means more leads, which impacts your bottom line. If you're in e-commerce or affiliate marketing, more traffic means more sales. If you're a blogger or an influencer, more traffic means more subscriptions and a wider reach. Also, ranking high in the search engine results gives people a good perception about your brand. It's good for your reputation, which is great no matter what industry you're in. Now, when it comes to actually doing SEO, there are many variables that a search engine takes into consideration, but generally they fall into one of these three categories: the content and user experience, site authority, and traffic. When it comes to the content and user experience, the areas to focus on are providing relevant content, the on-page and technical optimization of the page, and the internal linking structure and navigation of the site. In practical terms, if I'm searching for information on how to fix a window, the page I choose should be relevant to my search. If it starts talking about other stuff or it gets confusing, I'm out of there. The page itself should have a relevant title and structured content so that a search engine can make sense of what the page is about and who it's for. And the page should, whenever possible, include links to other sources, external as well as internal. This makes the page a more valuable resource and that can boost its authority. Also, those internal links can pass that authority onto other internal pages on your site. Now, when it comes to site authority, the things to focus on are the trust of your domain, and that can be affected by the age of your domain, your branding, the quality of your content and your traffic, and the number of referring links together with the trust of those referring domains. Once again, in practical terms, a newly registered domain is just not going to have the ability to rank that a well-established website has. Trust takes time to build. Also, if your content is questionable and your traffic is coming from dodgy sites, that can significantly affect your trust. And of course, the number of backlinks you have from other domains can have an impact on your ranking. If those links are good and the trust of those domains is good, you'll be ahead of the game. And finally, when it comes to traffic, the key is to drive the relevant audience to your content and keep them engaged. In other words, your content should have the right words to attract the right people and it should engage them. Now, SEO has its own lingo, and I recommend that you bookmark this section for reference. Here are the basic terms to know. Search engine spiders. These spiders are also known as web crawlers or bots. A spider's job is to index the content of websites all over the web. When you publish a new page on your website, the reason it's not in the search results automatically is because a spider hasn't visited yet. So search engines don't know your page exists. Search query. If I search Google for a local plumber, that's a search query. Search results pages. We usually call these SERPs, and they are the results a search engine returns for a search query. Google typically returns 10 results per page. Organic search, organic traffic. If you take a look at the SERPs, you'll notice there's almost always a few ads mixed in with the results. Results that are not ads are known as organic results. And here is the true ROI of SEO. If you're advertising to be on page one, that means that you pay every time somebody clicks your ad. If on the other hand, you're ranking organically, all that traffic is free. And the good news is that in this course, we're going to be covering everything you need to know to rank high and get some of that nice, juicy, free organic traffic. In chapter one, we'll dive into keyword research. In chapter two, we'll be covering SEO content development. In chapter three, you'll learn all about on-page optimization. And in chapter four, we'll cover off-page optimization. And finally, in chapter five, you'll learn about SEO performance tracking and monitoring. So when you're ready, head on over to the next lesson, and I'll see you there.